Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Fox 5 News this morning. Taking a look outside. It's a clear day, and that's how we want your mind to be. We want it to be clear, in focus, and we think that you think your gadgets help us become more productive, but that doesn't appear to be the case. So how do we stay focused with all of the new technology? Well, author Sean Stewart joins us this morning with his suggestions. And my friend, that was all for you. The nice, pretty shot of a clear, focused lens.
Awesome.
Which is what your book is about, right?
Absolutely. You know, you would think with all the tools and devices that we have at our disposal these days that we would be more productive with our time, right?
Right, absolutely.
But the reality is that only 2% of us are able to effectively multitask.
Oh, no way.
Yeah, so okay. Look at the rest of us, right? We're actually less productive when we are multitasking.
Oh, okay, so I see you have some visual aids, and sorry we didn't have a table for you.
But, no worries.
But I think staying in focus is making sure you could balance all of those visual aids on your lap,
exactly,
right?
Exactly, yes, exactly.
Okay, so what do you got? Well, give us some tips.
So here's the thing, right? I mean, my story of being the focus expert goes back to my childhood because I am the son of a very successful Hollywood screenwriter of films like A Boy in the Plastic Bubble, Blue Lagoon, and An Officer and a Gentleman.
Wow.
And my father inspired me to want to be a creative, successful person as well.
Okay. You know?
But despite my talents and hard work, I was all over the place.
Oh.
I learned that the key success factor in life is being able to focus on one thing at a time, and this changed everything for me. Helped me grow my business and helped me change a lot of lives. And so the bottom line is there are three focus mistakes that people are making.
Okay.
The first focus mistake is what I call the white rabbit.
The white rabbit.
Yes.
All right.
You know, from Alice in Wonderland,
Absolutely.
Right? I'm late for a very important date, right? So the whole thing about it is we're rushing around, trying to get more than 24 hours out of the day. But my suggestion to you is that instead of trying to do too many things, how about just focus on three core things that you could do that would really make a difference for you in your day?
Okay.
What are three results that are really going to change the focus of your life for that day?
Okay.
So that's the first tip, is focus on two to three results each day that are going to make a difference.
What is one or two of your results for today?
Well, result number one is to not drop this stuff in my lap.
And that's easy, right?
Yeah.
It's attainable.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. The other one was for me to get up and go to the gym and be focused and ready for this moment, because the morning matters most, you know? Get myself in the zone. All right, focus mistake number two is what I call the Paris Hilton, okay?
Yes.
So checking your pings, your dings, your posts, your tweets constantly throughout the day, right?
Right.
What is this doing? You know, this is taking our focus off of the people and things that matter most to us.
Okay.
Right? So instead of doing that, why don't we turn off the distraction, turn off all the noises, and instead learn how to focus on one thing at a time, maybe even set a timer so that you can actually focus on one thing for about an hour. Imagine what it would be like, even if it was Facebook, you focused on just that for an hour, you would build some pretty good relationships.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
I was worried where that Paris Hilton one was going. So that, okay, I understand. Okay, just making sure there was no video involved.
Yeah, no.
Okay, and then the third one?
Yes, the third one is what I call the Scarlett O'Hara.
You're going old school.
Yeah, with the wind, right? She used to say, fiddle-dee-dee, I'll think of that tomorrow.
Okay, that's
right? So we got into the zone of pushing things off tomorrow, and we never make what's important today happen, right? Because we're short-term focused. So what I say is, let's take tomorrow and bring it into the day. How do we do that? We get accountable. Maybe we get a coach. Maybe we get an accountability partner, something that's going to keep us to our word. And trust me, if you can get done the challenging things today, your life is going to be fun and fulfilling in the future.
Absolutely. And that's quite the opposite of the Annie theory, right, where the sun will come out tomorrow. You want to make sure it's happening today.
That's right.
Yeah.
I like that. It's another good reference for that.
Did you ever meet Brooke Shields?
I have met her, yes. She's awesome.
Wow. And and Travolta, too.
Of course.
I take it.
Okay. Yeah, I was a little kid.
If you missed it, his father is a
screenwriter.
Screenwriter, wow.
Yeah,
that's
Academy
so cool.
nominated screenwriter.
Wow, yeah, absolutely. All right. Well, good stuff. And you were saying that the first hour of your morning is the most important.
Yeah, and I put it all together for you with the focus formula.
Focus formula,
So the F stands for the first hour of the day lays the foundation. So you want to get into a zone.
Okay.
You want to meditate. You want to put yourself in a good state of mind. The O stands for one thing at a time, right? So just get that one thing done. The C stands for complete what you start, right?
Okay,
instead of trying to do a million, finish it. The U stands for under promise and over deliver.
Okay.
And the S stands for schedule ahead of time. So figure out what you're going to do.
All right, Sean, we will leave it at that. We really appreciate it. There's your book right there.
Awesome.
Focus by Sean Stewart. Thank you very much. I need Dad to be proud.
Yeah.